Water is a means of kind of commerce.
Good afternoon, Seattle. I'm Colton Mills.
And I'm Janine Longboy. Today we are here at the Hyatt Regency for a special edition of CKTV News in Seattle.
Seattle is known for being a melting pot of many different cultures and people from around the world, from Asians to Hawaiians and everyone in between. People here in Seattle practice their cultures around the city.
But out of all of the people here, Native Americans have some of the most interesting perspectives and cultural practices.
So our first story is about one Blackfoot Native American and his views on Native American culture.
I mean, it plays such a pivotal part, and it's at risk of being forgotten if these stories aren't told and shared.
Native Americans like Addison Houston know that Seattle is not the way that it used to be.
What we see around us is a metropolis that's one of the fastest growing economies in the nation, but really the culture of the First Peoples and the Native Americans is really oppressed here. And I mean, it's not something that you see anymore. You wouldn't come to this city and see the rich history that it has right beneath the surface. And literally, I mean, right beneath our feet here. This is built on an old settlement of Seattle, that the first one of which was actually burned down by one of the tribes in the area because they didn't condone the exploitation that was happening at the resources in the land here.
He also knows that it is important to preserve the Native American culture.
I think the Native American culture is worth preserving and worth protecting because it does give us that connection back to the land and back to the places we're from. Touches into something that is sacred, that recognizes that the earth is alive and is a living entity. It's a relationship that we build and foster.
Addison believes that there are many ways to keep this sacred culture alive.
I think really it comes down to respect for the elders and respect for the land. I mean, taking the time to learn about the cultures, learn about the First Peoples that are the indigenous peoples for the areas that we live in. It's really just that acknowledgement that there is a history that has almost been eradicated, but these people still are here, they're still around, and just taking the time to speak with people and learn about what their stories are and learn about their experiences, I think that goes a long way to preserving this culture.
Even though the Native American culture is slowly fading away, Addison Houston is proof that it is here to stay. For the Student Television Network, this is Via Jevenar.
As previously stated, Seattle is a melting pot for people and cultures all around the world.
But as time moves on, these cultures slowly die out.
So as an effort to stop this, next up, we have a PSA about conservation of cultures.
There are many people in this world, all with unique cultures. Culture is something important that everyone should value. It links us to our past and our future. So why are we just letting it disappear? Up until now, our ancestors have kept it alive for us. So why can't we keep it alive for future generations? Preserve the past, create the future. Native American culture plays a big part in the history of Seattle.
That's right. Without Native American culture, Seattle probably wouldn't be the amazing city it is today.
This next story is about a worker at the Duwamish Longhouse and Cultural Center and how she teaches people about the Native American history.
Throughout Jolene Ha's life, she has lived in a Native American culture.
I am part of a larger urban Native American collective here in the city of Seattle. I'm Duwamish and Suquamish. We are related to many of the tribes.
Jolene Ha's Native American culture hasn't been that respected over the past years.
Overall, I think the history of how the government and people have dealt with Native or Indigenous communities hasn't always been good. Historically, they haven't been treated very good, but you know, I know there's been some issues with people using mascots, Native American mascots. When they came to the Duwamish people or the Duwamish tribe and asked them how they felt about it, we're not offended at all. So, because we're Indian, so I don't really care. I mean, we don't care about that. And we'd like people to know that there were Indians here in West Seattle, so it doesn't really offend us.
Where she works, she reteaches the history or the culture of the Duwamish Native Americans.
People come in here, school groups come in here. In the Pacific Northwest, in the Seattle area, teaching Native American, Coast Salish, or Pacific Northwest Coast indigenous culture is part of the curriculum, so we have a lot of tours that come through here.
A tip she would give to people to revive and strive in Native American culture is to acknowledge the culture.
The best way that you can respect that culture and to give respect to those people is to acknowledge where you are.
As Jolene Hawes works to reteach her Native American culture, she also teaches others to respect and acknowledge other Native cultures. For the Student Television Network, this is Aaliyah Nero.
Native American culture plays a big part in the history of Seattle.
And these stories are only some examples of what Seattle has to share.
For the Student Television Network, this is Janine Longboy.
And Colton Mills.
Aloha.